गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू स्टूडेंट. सो वेलकम टू अगेन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन एमएससी फिजिक्स सेकंड ईयर. फॉर द सब्जेक्ट इज द एनर्जी स्टडीज एंड कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर फर्स्ट और मॉड्यूल फर्स्ट दैट इज द एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस एंड एनर्जी सिनेरियो. सो लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव टू सीन दैट समराइज. See there, the biomass energy, or we all know that, so that biomass energy which is obtained from the chemical compounds as well as waste material or agriculture waste or sludge or other waste material. So in this lecture we want to see the lectures on the geothermal energy, or you know that how extract this energy from the earth's interior part or earth crust part. Okay, so geothermal energy originates from the earth's interior in the form of the heat. Okay, so that geothermal energy is available in the earth interior part in the form of heat, or it is originate or obtained by the tapping of heat or tapping of the heat itself of the earth, like we have to say examples of the volcanoes, geysers, hot springs, etc. Because we have to know that in India also some places have the reservoir of the hot springs or hot water sources, or suppose if you see in the north part of the India, that is the Himalayan part or Himalayan ranges, so that many sources are available for the hot springs or geothermal energy resources, or from extracting from these sources the energy in the form of heat to use the extraction of the geothermal energy. So for this geothermal energy have some advantages and disadvantages or the limitation. So we have see here one by one the advantages of the geothermal energy. So advantages of geothermal energy. So here first advantages is it is environment friendly. Environmentally friendly. So we have to know that see by other energy sources, example like biomass energy or solar energy, wind energy, all of these renewable energy sources are eco-friendly. Similar also the geothermal energy is generally considered as the environment friendly or eco friendly. But this geothermal energy has few polluting aspect, but this geothermal energy as compared to the fossil fuel extraction, so these are the low polluting aspect as compared to the fossil fuel or emitting the greenhouse gases. That pollution associated with the conventional fuel sources like petroleum, gas, coal, so that carbon footprint geothermal power plant is minimum. So that if we have to see that is the average geothermal power plants release the 122 किलोग्राम ऑफ CO2, सो दैट एवरेज जियो थर्मल पावर प्लांट रिलीज एन एवरेज जियो थर्मल पावर प्लांट रिलीज हाउ मच ग्राम ऑफ कार्बन, सो दैट इज 122 केजी ऑफ CO2 पर मेगावाट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, सो दैट रिलीज 122 केजी ऑफ CO2 पर मेगावाट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. ऑफ पर मेगावाट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, सो इट जनरेट्स दैट इज 1.8% ऑफ द कार्बन इमिशन एसोसिएटेड विद द टिपिकल कोल पावर प्लांट, सो दैट इज परसेंटेज, सो दैट इज 1/8 ऑफ विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द टिपिकल कोल पावर प्लांट्स. Okay, so that's why it is environment friendly, because it has released some amount of greenhouse gases or carbon dioxide, but as compared to the extraction of electricity or extraction of energy, this power plant only 122 kilogram of CO2 per megawatt of electricity, that huge amount of electricity or energy is released, and that compared to if the power plant which is energy extraction from the coal power plant, so that is the 1/8 of this, so that is very minimized to create the pollution. So that's why this geothermal energy is the eco-friendly. Next advantages is the it has the renewable energy source. Second one is renewable energy source. Okay, so why geothermal energy is renewable energy source? So that advantages that does not require the combustion of any material. Okay, so that production of this geothermal energy that does not require, so for example, like we have to extract the energy from other like suppose fossil fuel, coal, petroleum gas, we have to require some energy in the form of the fossil fuel to extract this type of energy, but we want to extract or harness the geothermal energy does not require this type of fuel, so does this fuel which is have the less or negligible create the pollution, and that therefore it does not end with the reserves of this or the storages of this geothermal energy sources are abundantly available in the nature, and that are renew end to end or continuously creating or extracting this energy in the form of heat, so that process is continuously starting, and that's why this reason why consider the renewable energy and geothermal reservoir come from the natural resources and naturally replenish, so that's why its process is continuously renewable or replenished, so that's why it is the renewable source of energy. Next advantages is it is massive potential, it has geothermal energy has the massive potential. So massive potential because of why? So that worldwide energy consumption is nearly equal to the 15 terawatt, and that realistic estimate, the potential of geothermal power plant is varies between 0.035 terawatt to 2 terawatt. But the geothermal power plant across the world currently deliver, so that power plant is currently deliver 10.7 megawatt energy that are released or consume energy consumption is across the 15 megawatt is nearly in all over the world. But if we have to see that power plant installed in the world that have capacity is energy or installed geothermal heating capacity is nearly equal to the geothermal thermal installed power plant capacity of heating is nearly equal to 28,000 megawatt. So that's why this huge amount of energy collection sources are available in the nature. So that's why we have to see here, this is the abundant or very massive potential in the earth crust for the geothermal energy. So next advantages is it is stable. Next advantages of the geothermal energy is the stable. Why we have to see here, the advantages is stable because geothermal energy is the reliable source of energy, so that we can predict the output power of the geothermal power plant is remarkable accuracy, and that is not the case with the solar cell or solar energy or wind energy. So that's why we have to say that the geothermal energy is the reliable source of energy, because if you see that the extraction or harnesses the energy of the solar energy or wind energy, that is depends upon the weather component or variation of the weather or wind speed or solar radiation. But here the geothermal energy is extraction process is for day by day continue and does not variation for the extraction of the energy. So that's why this geothermal energy source is the stable. So these are the advantages of the geothermal energy. For example, starting the it is environment friendly, eco-friendly, it is renewable source of energy. After that we have to say it is a stable massive potential. So we have to see here the disadvantages or limitation of the geothermal energy. So we have to see here the disadvantages of geothermal energy. So first disadvantages is these environmental issues. Environmental issues. So what type of environmental issues create the geothermal energy? So that is, you have to see that few minutes ago it is eco-friendly or environment-friendly, but see this, like that point, so that create the small amount of the green gases or carbon dioxide gases. So that is, there is the abundance of the greenhouse gases below the surface of the earth, and if we have extracting this geothermal energy, so that some which is the mitigate towards the surface into the atmosphere, so that greenhouse, if we have extracting this energy, so some greenhouse gases which are released from the extraction of this geothermal energy, so this emission tends to the higher near the geothermal power plants. So that power plants are associated with the toxic gases like the sulfur dioxide and silica emission from this reservoir. So that are very toxic heavy metals, including the mercury or arsenic and the boron. That material is also released from this geothermal power plants, which is hazardous or most environmental issues from the life. Next one is the surface instability. Next disadvantage. So in environmental issue, you have to know that is the greenhouse gases which are released, or some toxic substances which are also released, which are toxic or hazardous from the life. Next one is the surface instability. Instability. For example, earthquakes example is most popular example for this advantages, because we have to know that, so that geothermal energy which has contain very hot fluid, or for example volcanoes, something that, so if we have tapping for the earth interior part, we have to extract this geothermal energy. So that construction of the geothermal plants can affect the stability of the land. For example, that earthquakes can be triggered due to the hydraulic fracturing, and which is intrinsic part of developing an enhanced geothermal system, that is EGS power plants, which is create the something situation like that have the earthquakes and volcanoes explosion, etc., that types of the concept. So that have the second disadvantages is the surface instability. Next disadvantages is, it is expensive source of the energy. Expensive. So because you have to know that energy resources extracted from this particular area, so we have to set up the power plants. And also these source like this geothermal energy power plant, so that commercial power plants project, that is the expensive. And that exploration of drilling the new reservoir come the steps of the price, that tag the $2 to $7 million for 1 megawatt electricity generation. So that huge amount of or substantial amount of money we have to require to set up this power plant. So that's why this is the expensive sources, that is $2 to $7 million USD dollar, that is USD require to 1 megawatt of energy or 1 megawatt of energy extraction. So that's why this is the expensive source of energy. This is one of the disadvantages of limitation. Next one is, it is location specific. फोर्थ डिसएडवांटेजेस इज लोकेशन स्पेसिफिक. ओके, सो दैट यू हैव टू नो दैट सपोज फॉर एग्जाम्पल सोलर एनर्जी एक्सट्रैक्शन और विंड एनर्जी एक्सट्रैक्शन इज इन द ऑल ओवर पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, बट वी हैव टू एक्सट्रैक्ट और हार्नेस द एनर्जी ऑफ जियो थर्मल एनर्जी. दिस इज लोकेशन स्पेसिफिक बिकॉज दिस रिजर्वायर इज हार्ड कम बाय द कन कम्स टू स्पेसिफिक कंट्रीज और स्पेसिफिक एरियाज, नॉट ऑल ओवर स्प्रेड इन द ऑल ओवर वर्ल्ड और ऑल ओवर एरिया. बट इफ यू हैव टू सी सम कंट्रीज एग्जाम्पल वी हैव टू टेक आउट और क्रिएट और हार्नेस द जो थर्मल एनर्जी दैट कंट्रीज इज गिवन द आइसलैंड एंड फिलीपाइंस मीट्स वन थर्ड ऑफ देयर यूज और कंज्यूम द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी वी हैव एक्सट्रैक्ट दिस जियोथर्मल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और जियोथर्मल एनर्जी. वी हैव टू यूज दिस एनर्जी फॉर द यूजिंग फ्रॉम द कुकिंग और हीटिंग ऑफ द वाटर एंड द हीट हॉट वाटर सप्लाई फॉर यूज दिस एनर्जी. नेक्स्ट वन इज द इट इज सस्टेनेबिलिटी इशू. Sustainability issues. So that is, you have to know that rainwater seeps through the earth's surface area, and that rainwater is depleted into the geothermal power plants or this wherever the reservoir of the geothermal energy. So that रेन वाटर सिप्स थ्रू द अर्थ सर्फेस एंड इन टू द जियोथर्मल रिजर्वायर ओवर द थाउजेंड्स ऑफ द ईयर्स. सो दैट स्टडीज शो दैट द रिजर्वायर्स कैन बी डिप्लेटेड इन द फ्लूड इज द रिमूव टू फास्टर टू रिप्लेस एंड दिस फ्लूड मस्ट बी इंजेक्ट फ्लूड बैक इन टू द जियोथर्मल रिजर्वायर एंड दिस यूज द थर्मल एनर्जी और जियोथर्मल पावर इज सस्टेनेबल if reservoir are properly managed. So that is the sustainability issues here, because this rainwater is seeps or going through that reservoir. So that is issue for the how to properly manage for this, because if we that rainwater is coming this source, so that is efficiency of this source or hotness of this fluid or material is going to decrease. So that's why we have to need to very well manage the sources. So that is also one is the sustainability issues. So